In lesson 2.5, students see a piece of ice placed on two separate black squares, and that the ice melts a lot faster on one square than the other, even though they're both at room temperature. Students then try a similar experiment. They put a piece of ice in a cup with no water, and a piece of ice in a cup with water. Both pieces of ice are at the same temperature, but one melts faster than the other. The question is, what's going on? Now, the big idea behind this lesson is just to get kids to understand that in the process of melting, energy is transferred from the surroundings to the ice, that the molecules in the ice begin to move faster, that their motion overcomes their attractions, and that it comes apart and changes from a solid to a liquid. We also want kids to realize that the liquid water takes up less space than the same amount of ice. So let's see how this works. If you have this equipment, you can use it, but if you don't, we have a video on the site that you can show kids. And here, this block is aluminum, and this one is like a plastic foam, and even though they're both at room temperature, the ice melts a lot faster on the aluminum than it does on the foam. And the reason is that the piece of aluminum is a lot more massive. There's more matter here. So this block, even though it's at the same temperature, has more energy. But one other reason is that it also transfers the energy much better. Aluminum is a much better conductor of heat than plastic is. And the same is true with the experiment that students do. If they have a piece of ice in room temperature air and a piece of ice in room temperature water, the water is much more massive than the air. There's just more matter here, so there's more total energy. It's sort of like if you had a drop of hot water on your hand, it wouldn't feel very hot. There's not much energy there. But if you had a whole lot of hot water on your hand, it would burn. There's just more energy and more matter. And the other reason is that water is a better conductor of that energy than air is. So let's keep going. We show kids an animation of ice so that they can see the crystal structure and that the molecules are in motion, even though it's just at 0 degrees. Molecules move all the time, except for at absolute zero. So 0 degrees is actually pretty warm compared to absolute zero. So that's the structure of ice. Now, if you heat the ice up, the molecules, their motion increases. We continue to add energy, and you'll see that the particles move even more, and eventually they're going to overcome their attractions and kind of collapse in on themselves. And this is when the water, liquid water, takes up less space than an equal amount of ice. So kids get to see that process at the molecular level. Now, we want students to be able to understand the entire range of state changes by the end of lesson 2.5. So we want to show that if you add energy to a solid, it becomes a liquid, that's melting. And if you add energy to a liquid, it becomes a gas, evaporation. And if you remove energy from a gas, it becomes a liquid, as in condensation. And if we remove even more energy, it goes from a liquid to a solid or freezing. We want also kids to realize that there's a bit of a difference between the way this all works in water than almost every other substance, only in that when water changes from a liquid to a solid, the molecules get further apart. That's very unusual. They almost always get closer together. In the teacher background area, we have, you can get to the teacher background area by using this link right here. There's a bit of extra information about the amount of energy it takes to get from one state to another. Like right here, you can see that water at 0 degrees, that's ice right there, but it takes a certain amount of energy to make it into liquid water. And then the water increases in temperature until it changes to a gas. And now it takes a lot more energy to change an amount of liquid water to a gas than it did to change the same amount of water as ice to a liquid. It's overcoming all those hydrogen bonds between all the water molecules. It takes a lot of energy. If you're in an NGSS state, the performance expectation MSPS 1.4 reads, develop a model that predicts and describes changes in particle motion, temperature, and state of a pure substance when thermal energy is added or removed. In lesson 2.5, Students see that if energy is transferred to the ice, the molecules move faster and that their motion overcomes their attractions and they change state from a solid to a liquid. And if you want to look at the foundation boxes, kids develop a model. We've been looking at molecular models all the way through chapters 1 and 2 to describe phenomena. And in this case, they carry out a pretty simple investigation. There's an element of heat transfer here from the surroundings to the ice, and that changes of state occur with variations in temperature. And for cross-cutting concepts, the idea here is for cause and effect. If the effect is the melting of ice, the cause is energy transferred to the ice, increasing the motion of the particles and the ice changing from a solid to a liquid. So thanks for watching and good luck with the lesson.